ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for your dream maker, Mr. Richard Simmons!
How's it going, old sport?
That's my old buddy, Jerry. You know what? Even though we haven't been working long together, and maybe some, you know, it happens to you, we have a good friendship.
Yeah, you're a good friend to a lot of people, though. And it's easy to become a friend of yours.
Oh, yeah. Jerry. Before the start of each show, the audience fills out a survey asking about their dreams. Now, this girl named Nicole was in our audience one day, and she wrote that her ultimate dream was to meet talk show host Sally Jesse Raphael. And she's my friend. She told us she's been watching Sally for 15 years. When Nicole was little, she'd even make her friends line up, and she'd interview them just like her talk show, just like Sally does. Nicole was so enthusiastic, I had to make her dream come true. So I flew her to New York to meet Sally Jesse Raphael in person.
Nicole, she wants to be a TV show host, and her favorite one is Sally Jesse Raphael. Let's go meet Nicole. Let me rub the sparkle in your nails.
Oh, stop.
Because I'm going to tell you something.
Stop, Richard.
I am going to let you go home. I'm going to let you pack because you're going to meet Sally Jesse Raphael in New York. You're going. You're going. Come on. You're going to go home right now. Wait, where's your bag? Do you have a bag? Here, you'll need this. Go. You're going to meet Sally. Go ahead. Well, I got to go too. One moment you're in L.A., and the next moment you're in New York.
I'm ready.
You have all your questions and stuff?
I'm ready. I do.
You have everything done?
Yes.
What is the first thing you're going to say to her when you meet her?
Oh, I love you, Sally.
You know, that's a really good opening line. It's a Sallywood.
Oh, wow. She's amazing.
Is there anything that she has not touched, like any topic that you think she should do?
Well, meeting me.
You know, beauty is part of being a talk show.
Oh, yes, it
absolutely
is.
Absolutely. It's just a lot of beauty. All right.
Oh, my God.
Oh, hi. 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 Hello. Hi. Sally, this is Nicole, and one of her dreams was to meet you. She wants to be a talk show host, and I said, well, I only know one that's just like the greatest, and I said, it's Sally, and now we're here.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Another dream. Maybe you could give her a couple little tips or something.
But we can't do that here, you know. We can't do it here.
No,
we had to go on a set. You have to sit on a set.
On the set?
Oh, my God.
On the set.
All right, you ready?
Oh. Yeah.
Okay, let's do it there.
Oh, okay.
As Richard will tell you, it's never, ever really glamorous behind the scenes, okay? Say hello to everybody.
Look at all the people that she hates. Hi. How are you?
Okay, here's what we're going to do. We have a young lady from Richard's show who wants to be a talk show host. So I said you've got to come out here and meet the audience. I hope I get her last name right. Nicole McKella? Now, we're going to test McKella out, okay? I guessed McKella host. Nicole host. I guessed Nicole host. Go.
Hi, Sally. It's great to meet you.
Thank you. She's beautiful, isn't she?
Oh, thank you. I wanted to first know, what has been your most embarrassing moment on TV?
I fell off the back of the set.
Who was your main influence or inspiration?
There wasn't anybody who sounded or looked like me, so I didn't have a role model. Nobody.
Well, that's why you're my inspiration.
There you go. There you go.
I love you, Sally.
Now, who was that? Who's that?
I love you, Sally.
Who could that be?
I love you, Sally.
been fun.
This is amazing.
And scary, right? She's very, you know,
she's good. She's very,
very
she was a little nervous and verklempt downstairs, but she got here and she was perfect.
She's fine. Oh, she's just fine. I like her red hair. Yeah.
Thank you all so much, and a big hand for Nicole.
Thank you, Sally. Another dream come true.
And I do mean thank you, Sally. Everyone, put your hands together for Nicole!
How are you?
It began with you just wanting a dream. Mm-hmm. And all of a sudden, it all came true.
Yes.
And now we're sitting here again.
I know!
What do you think?
That's great. It's very exciting.
What was it like for you, seriously? Because, I mean, all of us admire people. Everyone out there admires someone. And you admire Sally so much. What was it like meeting her?
Oh, it was very exhilarating. I was excited to go behind the set and go into her office and then go with her out into her audience.
And what was so unusual is you didn't seem... Did she seem nervous at all when she was interviewed? What did you learn from Sally when you walked out of that studio and then, you know, you got back on the plane? And what did you think about? What came to your mind?
Just that there's a lot of people that work there, and there's a lot that goes into, like, making a talk show.
And so after seeing all that, mm-hmm. you know, we kind of opened those doors for you, mm-hmm. those little dream doors. After seeing all that, what now, Nicole, is your next dream?
I don't know. I guess just maybe being an actress and getting out there and maybe starting my own show.
I think she can do it. Thank you, Nicole.
Oh, thank you, Richard. Thank you.
Another one. We did it. We did it. Hey, keep talking about your dreams. Say this, it is so important to feel good about yourself. Am I right? Before you can make your own dreams come true, you must like the way you are right now. I'm honored to introduce a woman who knows all about this. She's an author, she's a spokesperson for Revlon. She was elected twice as one of the most beautiful people in People Magazine's 50 Most Beautiful People. She's the host of Fashion Emergency on E! Entertainment Television. She's a gorgeous supermodel who's gonna help me grant a few dreams today. Please welcome the fabulous Emme!
You are so cute.
I've never met you in person. I've only seen pictures of you, and you're really beautiful. She's just slapping my hand. I don't know. How did you become a model? I mean, everyone dreams of this. How did you become a model?
I became a model because a bunch of my friends told me when I was in college and being a page at NBC, they said, "You're tall, you're blonde." I said, "But I'm size 12, 14, there's no way." I found out that Ford Models had a division called 12 Plus. And I said, "What the heck is 12 Plus?" So I found out that you could be a model at size 12, 14, and 16. And I went in 9 years ago and said, "What do you think?" They said, "Don't change a thing. We'd love to work with you." Now, that was a huge change from all the other things that, you know, people said that you have to be less weight, you have to take off 45 pounds.
In Hollywood, it's thin, thin, thin. They're now called the lollipops. Everybody you see on television, everybody you see on television. And I think this is a very bad image to set a
across to anyone.
We need to have diversity of size, I think, as well as ethnicity across all of the mass media so that we can see a reflection of ourselves and something to aspire to, not just one-dimensional.
Is she right?
I think.
She's very right.
I think.
She's right. And the thing is, you had to battle. You know, we all have, everybody here has maybe a self-image problem or two, and you had some.
I did. I had some very hard times where I felt, as being an athlete, I was a scholarship athlete in Syracuse University, and I was very strong and very athletic, but on an inner level, I was very confident as an athlete, but on an inner level, I was beating myself up that I was maybe too much or too big or too strong or whatever, and I would go through periods of not eating enough. And then go through periods of overeating because I was so hungry. And then there was a whole cycle that started.
And you know, you may not know this, but there are millions and millions of, we're not talking about a handful.
Yes.
There are millions of women in America today and men that are 12s, 14s, 16s, 18s. And you just have to be the best you can be.
Exactly.
You got to.
You can be large and in shape, and you can be thin and in shape. It doesn't mean that if you can only be thin and healthy. You can be larger and healthy. It's taking responsibility for ourselves, eating really nutritiously rich foods, as well as rest, as well as exercise. It's a balance of all that. And I know that you speak about that a lot, too.
You're a living model, and you're a living doll.
Thank you.
The reason I asked you here
is
because I wanted some of your energy to come out. And because I got a couple letters, and I want you to be a dream maker for me today.
I'd love to.
The first one I got is from a mother who wrote for her daughter, Jill. And the second one is from a girl named Rhonda. She wrote about her own dreams of becoming a model. These two ladies are backstage right now. They don't know you're here. They're like in separate rooms, and we just, just in separate rooms, just kind of, I guess, talking to themselves. So
they don't know why they're here.
They have no idea.
Okay.
So what I'm going to ask you to do.
I'm so nervous.
Don't be nervous. I'm the nervous one here. I'm going to ask you to come wait over here.
Great.
And then I'm going to bring them in, and they don't even know why they're here.
Okay? All right, great.
Okay, she'll be right back. Goals are really important and keep our lives on track and on focused. A lot of what we do on this show is helping people simply just achieve their goals. We're here today to talk to these two women about their personal and professional goals. Please, everyone, help me welcome Jill and Rhonda. Your face is saying, what the heck is going on here? Do you have any idea?
Not a clue.
Not a clue. Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine, and yourself?
Well, you're so, what's wrong?
Nothing.
Are you okay?
I'm just excited.
All right, well, talk to me for a second. Come on, I'm here. I'm holding your hands, talk to me.
I know. I'm so glad to be here.
Why?
I wrote a letter.
You did.
Dreammakers.
I'm going to get to that in just a minute. Mm-hmm. Jill, I got a letter from your mother. Okay. And I have it right here. I wonder if I can read this. Would you let me?
Sure.
You love your mom?
I love my mom.
You love her. You'll love her more after this. Dear Dreammaker, my dream is not for me. But find my daughter, Jill. I would like her to have a beautiful makeover. She is a fan of Emme, the plus-size model. Emme has been an inspiration for Jill and has given her so much confidence. Please, Dreammaker, help my daughter. Love, Maureen. Well... Tell me about your mom now. Tell me about Maureen now.
I'm speechless.
Are you? Why?
Because
They lied to me.
Well, it was a little white lie. No one's going down to the oven, you know? Rhonda, you wrote me a letter. Did you ever think I was gonna respond?
Yeah, but I just didn't know when.
Here's part of the letter that Rhonda wrote me. Dear Dreammaker, I'm 31 years old and have always dreamed of becoming a supermodel. I've been trying hard to make some dreams open up for me, but you know it's hard without the right connections. Sometimes it seems as if no one will ever let me prove what I can do with my talents. Richard, please help me make my dreams come true. Love, Rhonda. Why do you want to be a model? Tell me why.
Because growing up as a kid, I got picked on a lot, teased, told that I couldn't do some of the things in life that I knew that I was really doing. Like, meaning that I had no confidence, no self-esteem. I was a really, really overweight child. Not much love in my life by anyone.
Well, I gotta put some love in your life. And, you know, your mom wrote me and told me that you liked Emmy. Have you seen Emmy?
I love Emmy, yeah.
Is she gorgeous?
Yes.
I've just seen pictures. You've just seen pictures?
I've met her.
You've met her? What do you mean you met her?
In Chicago.
You just say hello to her and everything?
Yeah.
Were you nervous or anything?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Well, you know, both of you want the same thing. Your mother wants you to get a makeover, and you want to be a supermodel. And do you think I need some help to do this dream? I think I need some help. You know, I think I need an angel. I think I need an angel named Emmy! Come sit down.
Breathe.
Take a deep breath. Emmy is going to be an angel. She is taking you away to the dream makeover land. We're going to send you backstage. Emmy, look at these faces. Are you two ready for the makeover of your life? Because you're going to go get a makeover, and then later you're going to run down the walkway. Remember that dreams come in all shapes and sizes. Come on. Guess what we're gonna do?
What?
We're gonna check in backstage and see how Emmy's doing. Emmy!
Hi, Richard!
Emmy! Yes. Emmy's here! How are the girls doing, Emmy?
Girls, how are you feeling? Jill? Rhonda?
Excited.
Are y'all excited?
Very excited.
Yeah?
Getting hair blown out, new looks being put on, getting that glam supermodel look, Richard. Oh. What can I tell you?
What can I tell you? Only you could be. She's the goddess of beauty. We'll be back. The stories are on television all the time. A 17-year-old girl who was once an out-of-control teen. She did all kind of rebellious things, and at one point even planned to kill her parents. This is Michelle.
Thank you.
When I read that, and you were sitting here alone on the couch, what were you thinking about?
How much I regret it.
You regret it. You sent me a letter. Do you mind if I read it?
Mm-mm.
Okay. Dear Dreammaker, my mom and stepdad have been so good to me and helped me
get through some rough times. I put my mom through the most heartache. My dad died when I was 10, and from then on, I have been the worst kid I could ever think of. I made my mother cry so many times and caused so much depression and stress. I feel so bad for treating her this way when she has done so many good things. Please, Richard, surprise my mom and stepdad with something that they will never forget. I love them so much and want to make them feel like it. Love, Michelle. Michelle's mother is backstage. She's listening backstage, and we're gonna bring her out in a bit. It seems some tragedy happened in your life.
My dad died when I was 10, and I felt like I lost everything because my mom worked two jobs, and I loved him so much that when he died, that I didn't feel like I had anybody else in my life.
Do you remember the day your father passed away?
Oh, I remember it all too well. It was really sad. Like, my mom was home, and they had to have someone break the news to me, and when they told me that my dad wasn't going to live till the next day, I just lost it, and I completely lost control, and I said that nobody else is going to be in my life, and I just completely gave up on everybody and everything that was out there.
When you were feeling this way, very rebellious, very angry, you were angry?
Yeah, I was.
Who were you angry at?
I was angry at God. I was angry at myself. I was angry at the people out there, because I didn't know why this was happening.
But you were very angry at your mom, and you did things to your mom. What did you do to her?
I called her names. I treated her bad. I tried to kill her.
Wait, I don't want to pass over that. When you say you tried to kill your mother, did you plan that? Was that something you thought about?
I didn't plan it. I didn't think about it. I just, like, was so depressed because we got in a big fight a couple nights before, and I didn't want to fight with her anymore, so I just decided that it should just all end. But when it came down to it, I realized that if I lost my dad, I don't want to lose somebody else.
You have made such a turnaround in your life.
Thanks.
You did not do the things to your mother that you thought you were going to do. Tell us about your life now.
Well, after I moved, after we got in our last huge, which was the biggest fight ever, I told the cops to move me to California because I didn't know what was going to happen next. And so I moved out to California, and my uncle made me wake up and realize that she's the only one left, and that she's my only natural parent, and that there is no dead end, that you can turn around and be somebody better. And you can make your life a whole lot better than it is.
And you did, didn't you? I've got to meet the mother. Please welcome Juanita. So nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Your daughter has told me a lot, and I think it's time, as you looked at me and told me what you felt, I need you now to look at your mother, your very special, only mother, and I know you wrote a little something to read to her.
Mom, I love you, and I know what I did. I can't go back and change it, but I know I have changed. I'm sorry, and I love you now, tomorrow, and forever, and nothing will ever change that.
Juanita. I feel the strength in your hand. You're a very strong lady, aren't you?
I tried.
Oh no, you didn't just try. Your daughter's life turned around. Do you understand why she acted this way, and do you forgive her? And do you?
I do. I always forgive everything she does wrong.
Why?
Because I love her very much.
She's your daughter.
Yeah, and I give birth to her.
And she wrote me, and she didn't ask for anything for herself. She wanted me to grant a dream for you and your husband. That. Yes, she did. She said that you need some time, and she wanted to give you something. And we at Dreammaker wanted to give you something. So you and your husband are going on a trip to Hawaii!
Juanita, you and your husband are going to be staying in beautiful Maui at the Whaler, an elegant guest condominium resort right on the water's edge on Ka'anapali Beach, Maui, an enchanting island paradise, the Whaler from Premier Resorts.
What you saw here today is forgiveness and true love. Please take that home with you. No matter how difficult things may be, never give up on your family and your dreams. Thank you. You are so good to me, I can't stand it. A few weeks ago, I introduced you to a woman named Donna. She was very, very down on herself. She was embarrassed by a very large varicose vein on her leg. That one vein stopped her from doing so many things.
It protrudes and covers from my knee to my ankle. I know many people might think this is shallow, but it stops me from doing many things, such as going to the beach or wearing a dress to work. There is one man that has been doing this for 11 years. And I sent your email to this man. Please welcome Dr. Robert Dole.
I would be very happy to take care of this free of charge.
Free of charge.
We follow Donna. We followed Donna as she had a procedure done to make her vein vanish and her dream come true.
Hi, Donna.
Hi, Amita. How you doing?
Fine. I'm excited and nervous and overwhelmed. I'm in shock. Can't believe that it's finally going to get done.
Donna puts on a borrowed pair of shorts for the procedure. But first, before pictures are taken.
I might not have the best legs, but I'm going to be able to wear shorts. I'm going to be able to be more active with my kids. It's going to make me feel better as a person, as a mom, as a wife, so I'm very excited. They're going to see my self-esteem is just going to be boosted up completely. I feel good about it already.
Hi, Donna.
Hi, how you doing, Doctor?
Dr. Dole.
Dr. Robert Dole first uses ultrasound to pinpoint the vein's location.
Let us look inside.
He'll use the picture to target injections of a special solution into the vein that will make it vanish.
Discomfort from you? Minimal. All you'll feel is just the needle going through the skin. I've also had it done, so I know what it feels like.
Okay.
Okay, Donna, this will be the first one. You'll feel a little pinprick. What this does is to actually denude the inner lining of the vein itself so it collapses on itself and sticks together. And we inject the vein, and we continue to inject it until the vein disappears off the screen.
Okay. Okay, back it up. Right there. Back
right
it in
there.
Just a little bit. Right.
You got it.
No, in just a little. In just a little hair right there. Let her rip. Let her go.
There it goes. We got it.
That's it. That's it.
Yeah.
Not bad, huh?
I didn't feel anything. I mean, I felt like maybe a little tiny prick one time, but I didn't feel any of the other ones.
Five injections and 5 minutes later, and Donna's leg looks like new.
This is where the big bulging was. They're all collapsed and closed. But when all the healing is done, this leg is going to look just like this leg.
The healing is helped along by a very tight support stocking that must be worn for the first 2 weeks.
I mean, I'm looking at it now and I don't see any bumps or anything. It's just great. This is what my leg's going to look like tan. I'm going to go buy a pair of shorts. You know what? It's winter, so can't go to the beach, but I'm going to wear them anyway. It's going to be cold, and I'm going to wear shorts.
Donna is with us today. Please welcome her, Donna! Oh, sit down.
Oh, my God.
The first time you were on the show, you were so upset. You were crying. You were so depressed. It was, how do you, tell me now.
You don't even know. I mean, I am so excited. It's a ripple effect. You don't understand what you've done for me. I mean, I have new hair. I've lost 12 pounds.
12 pounds gone.
I have nails on. I feel so good. You don't understand. My family sees it. My friends see it. I'm just a happier person. I'm not crying.
I'm the one crying. You're not. What about, there was one thing that I kept remembering, shorts, wearing shorts.
Well, you know, right now it is off season, so shorts are hard to find. But you know what? I had a pair of pajamas that were shorts. I got them for my birthday. They still have the tags, brand new. And I've been wearing them. And you don't understand. My husband. My husband says, wow, I mean, in 8 years, he hasn't seen my legs. And he's like, oh my gosh, you have legs, you know? It's unbelievable.
When you were first here, your self-esteem was here. And now it's way up here. You look great. You look great. If you need to change, start with a dream. Let's stand up again. Was the best?
The best.
Emmy said it was the best. We've been here waiting to see the two new supermodels. You know what? How do they look?
They look gloriously glam. They really do. They look really
good. I've never heard that. Glorious, gloriously glam. Are y'all ready to see them? Well, let's begin with our brand new supermodel, Rhonda. This is what you look like before. This was your before picture. And look at Rhonda now!
Rhonda has a really incredible outfit from Lane Bryant with a sheet and then a coat on top of it. So
yeah.
If Rhonda wants to, when she's going to work or she's at a luncheon or anything like that, you take off the coat and then you have an evening outfit.
Like if I took off this coat.
Yes, but we, yeah.
Then you could take this and you could.
And wear it over your shoulders.
Instead of put it around
her
like this.
Add some color. It looks so divine and beautiful.
Really what
does.
A look! You like it?
You're such a beautiful woman. I think that if you just follow your dreams, you can really get into the modeling in your area. You should really try and do that.
Rhonda, now that you've been through this and you know, you just rushed really quick and did this, do you still have that fortitude to be a model?
Definitely.
I want to hear that again.
Definitely.
Whoa. All right now. You remember we had another girl. A beautiful girl. Here's how Jill looked before. Remember Jill who turned beet red when Emmy came out? Well, are you ready to meet supermodel Jill right now?
Jill's wearing an Onyx night evening look. You can find it on realsize.com.
Wow. If your mother was here, she'd go, wow! You just look gorgeous. How do you feel?
Thank you.
Now, I want you to talk to me now, because you didn't talk to me before.
It's unbelievable. I've never had anybody do my makeup or my hair or anything, so.
We were, like, running around her, and these two gals, just, like, with their hair flying all over the place and the makeup going on and the people are tweezing and everything. So they are visions of beauty.
You know, Emme is not only beautiful, she's a teacher. What did you learn from Emme?
Everything. I mean, well, I've never done my makeup, and so now I kind of know how.
Well, you have a little gift to give each one.
I definitely do.
You have a gift to give, because we got two girls now who are going to be supermodels. Hey, model your future after your dreams.
This is my book in
favorite time of the show. Wait. This is the time of the day where I usually make some instant dreams come true for the audience. But then I realized that the people at home might feel a little left out. So I'm going to try something new. Can I do that? Good. I call it Dial a Dream. I'm going to give away prizes to people watching at home, and I'm going to do it every day. Now, don't worry, audience. I'm going to still be giving you all gifts, huh? Don't put the pangs out. Okay, here we go. I'm going to call this lady Ruth Ann Singleton from Buena Park, California. Hello?
Hello.
Yes, is Ruth there, please?
This is she.
Ruth, hi, it's Richard Simmons, the Dream Maker. What?
It is?
Say hello to her, say hello. I'm right here live with you. I got your letter. You wrote me.
Uh-huh.
Because you have a baby?
Uh-huh. I have an 8-month-old granddaughter.
An 8-month-old granddaughter. And you didn't write anything for you.
No.
Wanted something for your granddaughter. You wanted a beautiful high chair and you wanted a car seat. Is
uh-huh.
that right?
Uh-huh.
Well, you know, I am the dream maker, and uh-huh. you can ask me and I'll give you anything. Jerry, what do we have?
Take a look.
And you know, it just turned around. And I have for you right now everything you asked for. Your high chair, and I have your car seat. Ruth Ann, are you there?
Yeah.
Ruth Ann, are you there?
Uh-huh.
You got it all. Are you happy?
Yeah.
I love you.
I love you.
Give a kiss to your granddaughter.
I will.
Bye-bye. Say bye-bye. Oh. All right, now, I am looking for, they give me these names on purpose. I'm Mona E. Franco. Oh, it's you! You are hiding. Come here. Did I pronounce your name right?
It's Imani.
Imani,
yes.
Imani. Imani, you said you wanted to rock with your friends.
Yes, I did.
What does that exactly mean?
I want to play in a band with my friends.
You want to play in a band?
Yes.
And what instrument would you be playing?
The guitar.
The guitar. Yes. Do you have it? Do you have it?
No, I don't.
Do you have it with
guitar.
You?
No.
Do you have one?
No, I don't.
You do now, Jerry! An electric guitar!
There you go.
An electric guitar.
And the speaker to go
with it. And the speaker. Honey, you can rock and roll. Whether you're at home or you're here with me, your dream could come true. Do you like it? Yeah, I'll hold it. Did you learn something today? I hope so. Because you must learn to like yourself today, the way you are now. If you don't, your dreams will never take shape. So I want you to look in the mirror today and find 3 positive things to say about yourself. Write them down. Send them to me along with your dreams. And remember something always. Keep dreaming.